Howdy folks, Brian Cusco here at Triple B. Snakes have one of the more unique physiological makeups of any animal out there. It's one of the only invertebrates that has absolutely no limbs. Today we're going to take a closer look at what makes a snake a snake. You're watching Triple B TV. Now, just to be clear, although I think it would be very interesting to dissect a snake, I've never done so. The information I'm about to give you is based off what I've read over the years. If I miss anything or get anything wrong, I welcome your input in the comments down below. Now, let's start with the largest organ in a snake's body, its skin. A snake's skin is covered in scales, which are partially made up of keratin, which is the same stuff our hair and fingernails are made of. If you'd like to take a more detailed look at the individual scales themselves, check out the video in this link here. These scales help to protect the snake against injury, drying out, and from friction. Since they lack limbs, a snake's body is constantly in contact with something, which produces a huge amount of friction. They shed their skin periodically as they grow, and where we humans are constantly shedding our skin, a snake sheds its skin all at once. Now, the next and possibly most fascinating part of a snake's anatomy has to be its forked tongue. They are constantly flicking their tongues in the air, picking up scent particles, which they bring back in and touch the roof of their mouth. At the roof of their mouth is what's called a Jacobson's organ. This gives them a directional sense of smell, and it's thanks to this organ that snakes boast a sense of smell almost as much as 600 times better than our own. Now, since we're in the mouth now, we might as well take a look at the teeth and glottis. Snake teeth are recurved and needle-like, designed to sink into their prey and keep it from getting away. Most snakes have four rows of teeth, two on top and two on bottom. They're constantly losing and regenerating new teeth, much like a shark. Venomous snakes have a set of hollow fangs, which are used to inject venom into their prey. Now, the glottis is an extension of the larynx that protrudes into the snake's mouth, just above where their tongue comes out. This tube allows them to continue breathing while they're swallowing a meal, which, depending on the size of prey, can sometimes take hours. Snake eyes! There are several types. Those with vertical cat-like pupils, round pupils, and even some with horizontal pupils. Now, it's a common misconception that you can tell a venomous snake apart from a non-venomous snake by the shape of its pupil. The truth is that some venomous snakes do have round pupils. Now, it's also thought that snakes with slit-like pupils are nocturnal and snakes with round pupils are diurnal. But upon further research, it seems that snakes with slit pupils tend to be ambush predators, whereas the snakes with round pupils tend to forage more for their food. Speaking of food, a snake's digestive system is very much like our own. They have a mouth, of course, which leads to an esophagus, which leads to a stomach, followed by small intestine into large intestine, and finally to the rectum and out the cloaca. They also have a liver, gallbladder, pancreas, and kidneys, just like us. The main difference is that everything is more elongated to fit down their slender bodies. Their digestive juices are also much more powerful, with the ability to break down hair, claws, and even the bones of their food. As for cardiovascular and respiratory, just like us, they have two lungs and one heart. Again, elongated to fit their bodies. The main difference is that their lungs are not side by side. The left lung tends to be up closer to the head and the right lung further down the body. The left lung is where the oxygen exchange takes place, and the right lung is more of an air sac that doesn't have any respiratory function at all. Now, how about a snake's skeleton? It's fairly simple compared to most other vertebrates. Basically a skull with a long spine, completed by ribs that run most of the length of the body. Where we humans have about 33 vertebrae, a snake can have anywhere from 200 to 400. That is incredible. And that's how they're able to coil up into big cinnamon rolls. Are we leaving anything out? I'm sure we are. Well, how about spurs? Some species of snake have little spurs right at the base of their tail. These can be manipulated by the snake to aid in breeding. and they're essentially the vestigial remnants of ancestral legs. This would imply that snakes evolved from creatures that had legs at one point. Pretty cool, huh? All right, guys, well, I think we're gonna leave it there for today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments down below. If you know someone who could use a little info on the basic anatomy of snakes, be sure to share this video with them. Next week, we're going to talk about ways to ensure that your animals are safe while you're away from home. And until then, you've been watching Triple B TV. Y'all take care. Well, blah, blah, blah.